Hi everyone, it's Dr. Deskins, and I want to go over our week one topic that we started with in module one. On my screen, you will see in module one, we had what is digital analytics. Now, when you review the feedback that I've given, regardless if you've earned 100% or less points than what you had expected, the first point I want to give out with digital analytics is that if you have taken our SEO versus SEM course, even our introduction to marketing, or any of our other marketing courses, strategic marketing management, any of those courses, all of them touch on different aspects of marketing. Digital analytics is, I would tout as the most important aspect of marketing, especially because we use a lot of technology. And right now, Google is the king on search engines. We do have a lot of other search engines available, but for the most part, most people do use Google. So we do follow, for the most part, what Google dictates. With that said, on digital analytics will always refer to what is written, but in the digital format, meaning a website or a blog, social media. Those are all digital analytics. All of the content on those platforms will be taken in consideration when a user types into something into the search engine and looks for something specific. On module one's topic, we were talking about the hub and spoke method. So on my screen, you'll see the learning objectives, module at a glance, our reading resources. For example, our textbook, we had chapters 1 and 2, and there were 3 questions here to address, and then chapter 3. So typically, when you look at your reading resources, that should be your first clue that this is information that you should be including in your information, whether it's written in paper format or in a lot of cases, in a lot of our courses, we have a blog. The reason we do a blog is it's a good way for you guys to keep your information in a set format. And then when you graduate, you can decide to rewrite your blog. You can keep it, you can expand on it, change the topic into something that you want, or you can delete it completely. As I click through the different metrics, I'm gonna move my other little screen out of the way a little bit so I can get over here. You have a blog guidelines and rubric that you should be opening and reading. And what you're going to see on this rubric, you're going to see your instructions about developing a professional organized blog post, apply topics, concepts covered in this course. And I refer you back to what I had just mentioned on the course, the chapters that you were reading for week one. And then utilize outside resources and or examples to support your positions. And when it says and or, just so you know, in writing aspect for all colleges across the globe, when you have a writing format, and most of the colleges in the United States for a lot of business courses is, courses we use APA format, and scientific and other, they may use MLA or Chicago style. It just really depends. But for what we do here at SNHU, for your marketing courses, business courses, we're going to be following APA format, which means this third bullet point where you utilize your outside resources, that means just refer back to your course book or your course resources for that topic. That means that you're going to provide your in-text citation, which with the source that you're going to use in that course book, for example, you would cite the author's last name and the year of the publication in your content. And then at the very end, you're going to list references, and then you're going to list those sources or the one source if you use just one at the end. Examples can relate to the source that you're using, but an example can also mean another example you want to give, and maybe you won't have a resource for that. But regardless, you always, to meet writing requirements for all of the courses, you have to include at least one source that's properly cited in the content and listed on your references at the end. I will always give feedback if you miss or maybe you skip, because my role is to help you write properly. And writing properly does run over to our blogs and our website pages. Google, for example, even though they don't tell you they follow APA format, when you look at SEO and SEM content, whether or not you've taken the course yet, or if you know anything or nothing about it, just to give you a quick tip, SEO is your search engine optimization, which means that everything written on a website page or a blog page should have enough content in it relating to the topic you're writing on, so that when a visitor, somebody searches on a search engine and they look for that information, that should be able to bring up your link so they could go there and read what you have written. Now, when we go to a blog, for example, we're going to have a set format that we follow. And these links I'm just clicking on are the links that are provided in your course. And like, for example, the one I have up right now is your blogging best practices that's listed in your module one. Please open these additional links and read through them so that you can follow the right format. Like, for example, a blog and a web page is very similar because they do follow the same type of content formatting. So you should have a bold heading on your page at the very top. You should have your written content, but you also need to have bold subheadings, and you should have at least one image, if not more, to draw interest. The goal when we write a website page, we write a blog, anything relating to digital analytics is content. Your content is key, meaning that whatever the topic is, for example, in this week, it was hub and spoke method. If you implied and you wrote about the departments and how they all relate to each other, that's fine. But if you didn't mention the hub and spoke method and go into detail about what that means, that's not giving content relating to the topic of choice. So if a reader were looking for that, first of all, they wouldn't find your website page or your blog because you didn't mention anything about hub and spoke. You have just like information kind of relating to it. So you want to be able to have your stats pull you up so that the digital analytics part of it brings your content closer to the front of the search engine. As most of us are users on search engines, when we look for some information, we see, we may look on page one, we may look on page two. I teach another course where we have students go to page five, and the specific reason is for that because most people don't go to page five of their search results, which means that you have great content, but maybe you haven't written enough of the buzzwords or the keywords, such as hub and spoke for this topic. So the visitor won't find you right away, and your website page and your blog is going to be pushed all the way back. And so you could be maybe on page 10 or 12, and nobody's going to find you. Now, when somebody comes, if they do find your website or your blog, and they come to it, the reason you want to have bold headings, you want to have images placed throughout, is because people are visual. We have roughly 2 seconds, if maybe three, to capture the visitor's attention, which means that when they come to your website page or your blog, they're going to look at it really quick. If all they see is just text, they're going to leave. And that's considered a bounce rate if you've taken any other courses. If not, I'm giving you some marketing buzzwords to, you know, bank to memory. When a person bounces off your website, that means that they're gone. It's just like a ball. They've bounced off. They're not coming back. They're going to go somewhere where they're going to have the information that they're looking for. If you have bold subheadings throughout your blog, similar to what you would see here, I will bring this up very quickly. I have a website here, a blog that has a title, it's got images, it's got content, there's citations. As you can see, everything is broken up where there's blog, bold subheadings, there's content, and then you have your final references. So that's just showing you very quickly what that blog looks like. And that's a very well-written blog relating to this week's content, the topic. The user is going, and the visitor looking for that information is going to find what they're looking for. Now, when a visitor goes to a blog or website, for example, in this case, a blog, if they go there and they see bold subheadings and they see images, because people are visual, they're not going to always start at the very top of your blog. They may jump down to the middle. They're going to look at the bold subheadings and say, well, this is what I searched for. I'm going to go here first. And then maybe they'll jump back up to the top and start reading through the rest of the content. That means that you're going to have an engaged visitor looking at your content and hopefully remain there longer. And if you're selling something or trying to gain viewers and visitors, that all means something. This all relates to digital analytics. So in the case, if I mention on my feedback that you made implications to it, but you did not mention the hub and spoke method, I do give you the opportunity to resubmit that. I would like it to be resubmitted by Sunday's date, sooner if possible, because I don't want anybody falling behind. But as we move through this course, please always open your rubric. Always follow the rubric. Look at those instructions. Look at that table on the rubric. I am going to open, here's this rubric again. And you'll see that all of your modules, module 1, 3, and 8, which are the key modules for this particular course, are there on the same, it's, you're going to open the same rubric for each of those weeks. And when you scroll down, you'll see this table here, and this is what I grade you on. And so when it asks if, you know, you've developed a professional organized blog post, what that also means is that you followed blogging content writing, that you not only have all the appropriate content required for this, the week's topic, but that you're following the organization, meaning the bold heading, the bold subheadings, and the image or images, and that you've properly used your in-text citations and written your sources on the references list at the very end. Then you, and if you always look at this first column on the rubric, then you'll gain the most possible points, because this is what I'm looking for first. If I don't see what is required here, and it's like, well, you kind of almost have it, I'm going to have to go to the needs improvement. And you can see that's a great big, you know, that's a big jump. But it's only 55% as compared to 100%. And there's only three sections, which means your grade is going to suffer because the scoring is so heavy with only three main segments, meaning that your content is key. Following the topic for the week is crucial. Make sure that you're always looking at the information, including that information. I do give the opportunity to resubmit. So if you get a grade that you don't, you're not happy with, just ask me, you know, Professor Deskins, can I please resubmit it? I'd like to make corrections. I'm more than willing to help with that. I do understand that there may be professors or instructors out there that just let students slide by and just give grades. I'm not like that. I want to give valuable feedback. I want to make sure that you are learning your writing skills in marketing. It's very important that our writing skills are up there, that we are giving credit to our sources because we are working in digital analytics and we are writing in a digital environment using technology, using the internet. We have to be very careful. We have to give credit to our sources of information. The last thing you want to do is to write a blog, for example, have something out there on the internet, and then have the original author come back and say, hey, you either take this information down or I'm going to sue you. Or you've taken trademarked information and you've used it and you haven't given credit to me, I'm going to sue you. This happens quite a lot. Yes, I have been threatened in the past. I've been doing this for almost 40 years and I've seen the internet start. I've seen everything transition. There's been lots of changes because, you know, the internet has grown. And so all of these key terms and these important tips have helped, you know, they've evolved over time, and Google has been the driver on this. And so we try our best to make sure that we're meeting these guidelines. Now, I'm not going to get so strict when it comes to following, what Google tells us for digital analytics. Again, I'm only looking at our course rubric. When I go back, let me see which link it was, this one. I am looking at this table, but at the same time, I'm making sure that, you know, are you including everything that is required that module one talks about? You know, did you include the wording, you know, the terminology of hub and spoke method? If you didn't, then you missed the important information. You can see that all right here in your module where it says refer to chapter one, which defines that. So that means that you need to break it down. You need to explain it. You need to make sure you're following this rubric link right here and that you're including all of that information and then creating a well-drafted blog. Now, if you forget to do bold subheadings, if you forget to add an image, I'm not going to mark you off for that. It is incorrect to not include that information on a blog, and I will mention it and ask you to please do so in the future, because that's just how a blog is written. And that is my goal, is to help bring all these key elements to your attention so that I can make you better marketers, better bloggers, and help you follow everything required for digital analytics, because there is a lot involved. And again, I am here to help you and actually help you learn this material. So if you have any questions, as always, please ask. Otherwise, if I have asked you to go ahead and resubmit by a certain date, please do so, and I will re-review, and then I will update your grade accordingly. I hope this information helps. I know it was a lot to hear, but again, I like to be as engaged as possible and explain as much as I can. Thank you so much for watching, and have a great day. You guys did a great job. Bye-bye.